Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Nurse Pauline RN. I will be uploading my videos on Tuesdays and Thursdays Eastern Standard Time. The goal of my channel is to assist nursing students to be successful in their fundamental of nursing exams, especially the first exam. I'm dedicated to the first exam because if you can get 80% in your first exam, you can make it to the end of fundamentals. My second goal is for you to be successful in your final exam in fundamentals of nursing. Before we go any further, I'd like you to hit your like button that's on your right, just below the video. Hit your subscribe button below the video that's on your left side. That's your red button. This will allow us to send notification as soon as I upload a video. Subscribing, guys, do not mean you're gonna be charged a fee. Make sure you turn on your notification button so as soon as I upload a video, you can be notified. Right by the subscribe button, there's a notification key. You can either mute it or unmute it. Make sure it's on unmute so you can be noticed. The topic of my video today is about culture. On this channel, we do answers only, guys. You're here only to relax and key in to the things you do not know. Okay, according to the Office of Minority Health, the thoughts, communication, actions, customs, belief, values, of racial, ethnic, religion, or social group is known as culture. Asians, they are known to prefer their family members to ambulate with them rather than a staff member or someone else of another culture. So please bear this in mind. If you have a patient who is at risk for fall, maybe with a walker that you're very concerned about, or maybe a post-op patient, for the patient's safety, you would allow the family member to ambulate the patient, but make sure the nurse should be there as standby if the patient is not safe. Language is a symbolic aspect of a person's culture. If a patient is praying in the room when you go in to administer your medications, please exit the room and return after the patient has finished praying. Then you can administer your medication. We have to respect cultures and religions of patients. Health disparity is a particular type of health differences linked with social, economic, environmental disadvantage. Culture competence care delivered with awareness of aspects of the patient. Cultural diversity process that occurs when minority group living as part of a dominant group within a culture loses the cultural characteristics that is different. Culture norms and value traditions are passed from one generation to the other. Transcultural nursing is a study of cultures to understand differences. Oppression is formed an informal system of advantage and disadvantages tied into a membership, example, work and school. A culture norms and values are passed down from one generation to the other. Intersectionality is a framework where all belongs to multiple social groups within social and political contents. The focus of cultural health is the literacy of the patient and family-centered. Social determinants of health are conditions people are born with, live, work, shaped by distribution of money and resources. In marginalized groups, we have poor health outcomes, death at an earlier age, because of individual genetic behavior, public health policy, community and environmental factors, and lack of quality health care. Vulnerable problems are people with disabilities, chronic conditions, mental illness, substance abuse, cultural, racial, ethnic minority, rural, urban, poor, homelessness, and poverty. In care coordination, we have care transmission, which is a process in which patient care is shifted from one setting to another. It is the central responsibility of all healthcare professionals. Cultural assimilation is process, minority is process, minority group, living as part of a dominant group. Cultural sensitivity is being aware that cultural differences and similarities between people exist without assigning them value, positive or negative, better or worse, right or wrong. Your culture is no better than another culture. Cultural awareness is to understand cultural differences do exist and to be sensitive to and respect differences when interacting with patients whose customs are world view different from our own. There is a cultural awareness checklist. One, you identify the patient's preferred method of communication. Patient may need medical interpreter. Two, identify language barrier, example, verbal or non-verbal. And three, identify your patient's culture. A as a culture competent nurse, recognize your own background and set aside biases and prejudice. Culture is a little bit short today, so I'm gonna go on to informatics, which is also short. When we talk about informatics, we're talking about information technology, computer charting. We will go further into this in your chapter for documentation. EMR stands for Electronic Medical Record. It's mandated by Joint Commission. The EMR is a permanent legal record. It's valid in a court of law. In documentation, in your computers, you chart only facts. If you chart subjective data from the patient, use open and close asterisks. For example, I fell or I feel as, these are subjective. Charting objective data is data that the nurse observes. She uses her senses. She smells, she feels, she sees, she hears. Those are all objective data. If the patient tells you about something that happened at home, you'll just chart it into your medical history. When you chart, please chart correct date, correct time. You chart in black ink. Do not leave any spaces for someone to come behind you and chart in between those spaces. At the end of documentation, you chart your full name followed by RN. Please document assessment and interventions. Do not document someone else's opinion about the patient. Assessment and intervention should be documented about the patient by the RN. When the nurse is going to talk to a physician on the phone, you should have all the information in front. Gather all your information, your labs, if you need lab results. All your information, maybe reports, maybe surgical updates in the computer. Please have these if you're going to talk to the physician, because the doctor may need to order a telephone order on the phone. And if you don't have all your information about the patient, you're going to have to hang up the phone. You're going to have to go back and find out all this information. Then you're going to have to go back and phone your doctor. And it's wasting your time. It's time away from the patients. And it's wasting the doctor's time. So have all your information if you're going to do a telephone report. And student nurses should not do this without an RN present. When you restrain a patient without a doctor's order, this is false imprisonment. RNs practice according to state guidelines. RNs should not practice beyond their scope of practice. A nurse in labor delivery cannot work on an ICU floor. Please practice within your scope of practice. If there's some issue on the floor, please follow your chain of command. If you have complaints or concerns, sometimes on the weekend, your charge nurse it's your nurse manager may not be there because they usually work from Mondays to Fridays. If you have any concerns on the weekends, communicate with your charge nurse. During the week, communicate with your manager. And on the weekends, if there's no manager, you will communicate from your charge nurse to the nursing supervisor. You follow your chain of command. ARN is a mandatory reporter. All RNs must report abuse. ARN is a mandatory reporter. Please report abuses. It's your facility's responsibility to report diseases, example STD, TB. It's your facility's responsibility to report STDs, TBs. Okay, guys, that's it for today. Hope you had a good week. Keep on studying. Keep on doing your index cards, multiple choice questions, very important. Come back to me on Tuesday, narrow everything down and study with me. Just relax and I'll see you. Have a good week. Love you all. Take care. Stay blessed.